Joining us, former coach of the Vancouver Canucks, current coach of the Columbus Blue Jackets, John Tortorella. John, how are you?
How are you guys?
We're well, thanks. Obviously, the conversation over the last couple days, and it'll continue into the weekend, is about Daniel and Henrik Sedin as they put a bow on 18-year careers. All of it spent in Vancouver, and the city is responding accordingly. When you coach the Sedins, the three of you all got on pretty well. You all developed a pretty good relationship, although it was only the one season together. Can you kind of explain to us why or how it was that you guys developed that relationship and got on so well with each other?
I don't know. I can tell you my point of view is that I remember our first camp, and we had some pretty heavy testing, and we had a run test. I think at that particular time it was a three mile test. And I watched those two guys. I watched how they handled themselves through all that testing. And I said, they don't have to say a word, and you can see their leadership qualities right away. And it just, you know, we discussed on how we were going to play. I took some of their ideas, listened to them. I just think we connected. To me, it was an honor to listen to them and see how they feel about the game, what they see in the game, because coaches basically have no clue half the time as far as what's going on in the ice. We see things in a whole different way than the players are seeing, especially those two guys. And it just developed. It developed. I was pushing the team, pushing them pretty hard. They wanted to be pushed the same way. They were pushed the same way. And it just developed a relationship that I treasure. One of the most disappointing things for me was just only spending 1 year there for a number of reasons, but that being the top one as far as being with them and watch how they go about their business and learn from them along the way. So it was pretty cool.
You know, the public here in Vancouver in the media, we obviously don't get to see behind the scenes, but what we do see publicly are just two really stoic, committed guys, know how to handle themselves publicly. Is there anything different about them behind the scenes that you've seen that maybe the fans and the media don't see about these guys?
Well, I just saw a total different level. I've watched them play. They're great players. We all know that. But where they don't get enough credit, guys, is those are two of the most competitive people I've coached. I've been very fortunate to have opportunities to coach a lot of players in the league over the years. Those are two of the most competitive people that I've coached. And I don't think they get enough credit for that. Everybody knows how good they are. But some of the things over the years and perception of them, they played in the areas all the time. Were they going to fight or, a couple of things happened to them in the playoffs with Marchand and people were making judgments on these guys. No one really knows unless you played with them and watched them as a coach up close and personal to see how they competed in those areas all the time. They don't get enough credit for that. And that's what I respect most about them. Because they're gentlemen. They are just first-class people out of the rink, but they're competitors within that game. And I have a true respect for that, and they don't get enough credit.
Yeah, it's interesting. I was speaking with Lawrence Gilman, the former assistant GM in Vancouver, a couple days ago, and he was saying that the perception and the label about the Sedins being soft, and the interesting line was he did their best work in places where many hockey players don't want to go, along the boards, in the corners, and taking pucks. And then I guess that kind of speaks to what you're saying about how competitive they were, where they did a lot of their work in places where it's not very comfortable, but they were so driven to succeed, they knew they could get the success there.
Yeah, and it does. It pisses me off some of the connotations that go along with the Twins over their career. And I think people make such quick judgments because they hear it from another person and another person, and it becomes kind of reality. Perception comes to reality. Those guys, you know what, guys? The best compliment I can give them is I had a chance to, before our game just the other night, we sat down for 20 minutes in the doctor's there in between the rooms, and I had a chance to sit with both of them there. And when I left there, you know, I knew they were done. And but you know what? The game are going to miss. We're going to lose two really good players and two better people. And that's what loses here. The National Hockey loses two great people.
We're speaking with John Tortorella, current coach of the Columbus Blue Jackets. The Canucks are committed to going younger next season. Trevor Linden was on our station yesterday and said Canucks could be extremely young. Now, some of your famous words leaving Vancouver was that you said that the core was stale, and I don't think you were wrong in hindsight in saying that. What is the you've had some success coaching some young players. You know, Columbus right now, that's a young team. You got a lot of young guys playing key roles. I think back to the Rangers teams that you coached. Or McDonough was young. Ryan Callahan was young. What is the key to coaching those young players?
Well, especially now, guys, and listen, Trevor Linden, I think it's fantastic that, you know, in Jeff Gorton in New York, I think it's great that they get in front of it and basically tell the people, this is where we have to go. And that's what was frustrating to me a little bit there in Vancouver. We needed to go in that direction, and that's no disrespect to that core that was there. There was a great core with Juice, Bieksa, and all those guys, but we needed to change that. And when you start bringing young guys in, especially in today's game, where really it is a young, dumb league, and I say that not in a negative way. It is a game of mistakes anyway, but even more so now. I think you have to be really careful with a young team is not to overcoach them and let them make the mistakes. And I say this now, probably 10 years ago in my career, I would have choked the life out of young kids by correcting them too much and really turning them and not allowing them to play. I think as the league has gotten younger and younger the past few years with so much skill, and now with Vancouver going to that mode, I think that's where Travis and his staff, you got to turn away sometimes and let them make the mistakes and let them go try to make that same play the next time they're on the ice. I think that's how they'll become better. But that has to take patience, not only through the coaching staff, but the people around the coaching staff too. And that's an organizational philosophy. And I think that is the key thing when you get to a rebuild or whatever you want to call it. Everybody's afraid to say that word, but that's what it is. I think you have to have an organizational philosophy that you stay with one another through the tough times through it too, and not listen to the noise and just stay with your plan. I think that's very important.
Is there still some value to having some veterans around the group, though? Because, I mean, that's always Absolutely. The debate in Vancouver. You know, you go, okay, well, how many veterans do you need? Can you be too young? And can you hurt young players' development? It seems to be a very fine line or a very fine balance that you have to strike.
Absolutely. It's a great question, and you're dead on, because it can't be all young, because quite honestly, before you even get on the ice, the most important part of developing young players is teaching what it is to be a pro. How you prepare, how you eat, how you handle the media. A media that's a strong media out there in Vancouver. How you travel, how you're living, everything. And you need some veteran people to show the way there and be in the room for those guys to be asking questions about certain things. Or a veteran player watching a young guy, how he's practicing, and say, hey, listen, that's just not good enough. That's not how we go about our business. That is the most important part of developing a young team before you even get on the ice and play the game, is what you are as a pro. That can't be done with all youth.